instruction it is. Okay, so we saw different variants of some instructions. Okay, so I'm adding few instructions in a code which will give you brief idea about like what exactly I'm talking about. Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So let us try writing this code. Okay, so in this code, yes. So section dot data. Sorry, let us not take section dot data. We'll take section dot text. Global main. Add ex comma 10. Instead of EX, I will take EBX. Subtract EBX comma 10. CMP EBX comma 10. So here I will take a bigger number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, see here, like how many instructions I have added here? 3. Fine. So apart from this, let us first try this. So what you can see here, there are 3 instructions. One is add, one is sub, and third one is CMP. And I have both the operands are same. Fine. So let us try to save this and then let us go on the terminal and let us translate this. Okay, now see the instruction that is shown over. What is the similarity with all these 3 instructions? Okay, one can unmute and let me know, like, do you see any similarity with the object code that is shown over here? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 81 in all 3. And if you recall what we discussed earlier was, or what we see, that whatever the instruction that you have, depending upon top code would be fixed. Now, if my instruction is add, my instruction is sub, my instruction is CMP, for each of them, like it is showing me 81 as an op. How come it differentiates that this is add, this is sub, this is CMP? Can you see this? Okay, understood what I am trying to tell you here.
Sir, your
if
voice is
my breaking. Operand types are same and instructions are different, though breaking, is it? For everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Is it okay? Or still there is some disturbance? Yes. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Properly?
Yes, sir.
Samiksha, can you hear me? Samiksha Yola?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us assume, like considering these two. Yeah. So my question is, like, if I see these 3 instructions, okay, the difference between these 3 instructions is, like, first thing is, like this, if I talk about similarity, I have operand types are same for each of these 3. my instructions are different, add, sub, and CMP. When I try to see their object code generated for each of these three instructions, I do see that each instruction took 5 bytes, rather 6 bytes, okay, to show the translation of object code. First byte was the opcode, second byte was the mod RM thing, and next 4 are used for the 32-bit representation of the number, because it can be fitted into 32 bits only. So 4 bytes would be used for this data. Now, if I try to compare these three, so suppose if this code, whatever the original code is, okay, so let me check, do one setting if possible. Now, if I hide this code, using this, how exactly I would be able to tell that first 81 is add, second one is sub, and third one is CMP? I should be able to distinguish between them. Understood my, now the problem? What I'm trying to tell, if I have this kind of translation, how will I conclude that this is add instruction, this is sub instruction, and this is CMP instruction? Though here in this case, we know that, or whatever way, like it may be CMP even, we don't know. On what basis we are going to check it? Now, if you try to see, mod seems to be same for each of them, because it is C, E, and F, that means mod is 1, 1. Rest of the thing is changing for the registers. Fine. So let us copy this code, copy this translation, and let us try to see how the difference is found out. So let me paste it. Okay, so we are concentrating on now this part. Okay, so let us take one by one each one of them. So let me take first this. So let us do reverse engineering for this. Okay, so let us differentiate between 81. Then we have mod RMS C3, and then my data 7856 3412, so which is written with small Indian notation. Okay, so this is my immediate data that is added as per instruction format. Okay, so this is an opcode. Now I see that for each of these three instructions, if I try to compare, each of them is having instruction opcode as same, correct? So in this case also, if I try to compare, I have opcode as 81. My mod RM seems to be EB, and my immediate data is like this. Fine. Same case with the 6-line. Now, if at all I have to differentiate between them, on what basis I am going to check or find out that this is add or this is sub, now with assumption that this is not visible to us. Okay, this is we are assuming. Now let us try to dissect it. So 81 we don't care right now. Let us try to write this mod. So mod, so C means what? ABC 10 11 12 12 means 1100, correct? And 3 is 0011. Fine. Okay, same thing we are having here EB. So let me write here C3. So here let me write EB. How will you write EB? E means what? 1110, correct? And then B, 1010, correct? Am I right? Or there is I made some mistake? B is what?
No, yes, sir,
it should be 11, na? 1, 1, correct? 1 is missing. Am I right? This is B, 11, 8 plus 2 plus 1, 11, correct? Okay, let us go to this 81 to be more instruction opcode, correct? Then we have FB, and then we have 7856 3412. 12. Fine. Now we have to write this FB. So 1111, then B. 1011. Okay. Now let me differentiate this mod. Okay. Let me write this in the pair of like first two bits for mod. Second thing is 000, and last one is 011. Let me do the same thing, same treatment for this 11101010011. Correct? Let me do the same thing for this case. 11110. Okay. And last one is, sorry, have I made mistake? Yeah, it is 111. Correct. And then lastly, 011. What is common here in this mod? First two bits are same, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And last three bits are the same. Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is the representation for EBX? So if I go with this, EX, ECX, EDX and EBX. So if I start with this, sorry, it should be EX. I made a mistake. So this is 0, 1, 2 and 3. Can you see this 3? 0, 1, 1. Correct? That means what? This last bit is telling us, last group of three bits is telling us that this is for EBX. Whenever you have an instruction, no matter what register you have over here, and a 32-bit immediate data added along with add instruction, then in mod RM, these three bits will remain 000. When you replace that add by sub, it will make it as 101. And whenever it becomes CMP, it becomes 111. So now let me try writing this. Suppose if I have something like this, mod to be 11111111. What do you think? What instruction this would be if I write mod to be like this with assumption this is 81 to be opcode? What this will represent? FF, correct? So what if I write some instruction? Okay, which instruction possibly can have this 81 FF among the above three? Like don't consider this instruction, by the way. Yeah, we have to consider only these two parts. Okay, 81 is shown, correct? Where can I find this as 111?
CMP.
CMP.
So what that register is now, last register 111 means what?
EDI.
EBP.
Okay, so suppose EDI. If I write this CMP EDI 0x12345678, I should get 81FF. Correct? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let us try this. Emax. Let us control Y. If I write here EDI, let us translate this code. Let us generate p.lst. Can you see 81FF? Correct? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what we learned here? Few instructions sometimes will have same opcodes. Okay, like in this case, we can see, like I know these three instructions, that's why I have written these. There might be few more instructions which may have again this 81 as common. Correct. What if I write XOR? Okay, let us go to this PDF. Now you can see here, this is subtract. Correct. See this 81. Register memory 32, immediate 32. So now, suppose if I do some modification in the code like this, Okay, so this we know that this would be mod 1 1. Mod would be 1 1. So if I go to that mod table available with us in above pages. Now see mod 1 1. Now I have used there a specific thing, which is the immediate one. Okay, what do you think? What will be taken for this? What it will take? So if I see this D word new var, okay, with add instruction. So let us go to add. Where will do you think my instruction would be fitting over here? In which case, if I have add D word of new var, where do you think it should fit? What should be the opcode? So should it be this? Actually no, because we have immediate data, so it should be setting it somewhere over here. But what opcode should, what mod it should take in this case? Okay, let us try this code too. Have you understood what change I made? We said register memory 32, like as per the add instruction. This add and this add, we are talking about both the instructions. So here I have register, here I have memory. Correct. Now if I talk about this, where is immediate data found here? If I add with EAX, then there is a separate treatment. But if I don't have anything with EAX, okay, now whenever I write EAX, it will go over here with 05. Whenever I write a memory, whatever the value that is available with mod 1 1, with respect to EX at one place, that should be picked. Okay, let us try this. Then you will understand what I was exactly trying to tell you. Translate this and let us check this code. Now see, you got 81. Correct? 81. Then you got this new wire thing like this. And we got 05 here. Okay, now let us go above with that mod RM byte and let us see where is 05. It should be from EX column. Can you see somewhere 05 mod? Where is mod 05? Where is 05? Sorry, we are talking 30 dB. This is 05. See this one. So it is talking about now displacement. Suddenly, earlier the mod was different, correct? With my register, when register was included there. Right now, I do see that for the displacement, whenever I added one memory, it took mod 00. But when register was involved, it took mod 11. Correct? Are you with me? Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Any question? Do you think like you have one? I assume that you, some of you are having question here, but may not be able to say phrase it properly. So I'm asking you, do you have any question with this, whatever I tried telling you? Okay, now let me show you why I am asking this code, this question. For this add EBX and for this add DWORD, both of them seem to be like, I could have interpreted as add register memory 32. So it could be register or it could be memory. Correct? Now, when it is a variable added in a bracket, ultimately mod would be picked as mod 00 for this case. Now, if you see 5, how 5 would be represented? 0101, correct? 0101. So if I see 101 as an a code perspective over here, this is my 101. Because it was 0101. So if I pick last three digits, it is 101. So it picked it. Now this mod, changing mod, tells me here, whenever I see this kind of stuff, that there is some memory involved, which is a variable declared in one of the section. One of the section. So when I try seeing this code ultimately above, whenever there is a square bracket, it could be either from data section or BSS section. Whenever I see this race written, that means what? It is from BSS. You do give any name there. You say your name, for example, Suraj. If I write add D word of Suraj, comma 0x12345678, that also should suffice. It should work out appropriately. Correct? Are you with me? Now, what if I add EX there? Now you will see that, like when we add EX over there as an perspective with the code, let us see this. Let us try to translate. Let us generate code. Now you will see that when this EX came into picture with add, if other registers are there, I could see here 81. But when I had EX, I subsequently can see that there is 05. Correct? Are you there? Yes, please. Now, why that 05 was added? Let me go here with add and see what is 05. It says whenever you are using EX and immediate data, then add it appropriately, like with the opcode to be 05. Correct? But whenever I have something like this, RM32 immediate A 32. It is talking about 81. But then if it is the case, why still my memory, which I used there like this, though it picked 81 as an opcode for it, So if I try to translate both of these codes, let us do this in this file. Let us go by this. So this is line number 9. Let us, so this 3412 is already added. So let us take this 8105. So 8105. This is our code, correct? So 81 would be written as it is. Let us not much worry about. 05 would be like this. 0000 0101. Now, if I try to compare both earlier add, which I had with EBX, okay, you will see here that this 000 with add was taken same here. Correct? With this 8105, and this 101 came into picture. Now, when I do talk about 101 here, if I compare 101 over here, what possibly could be 101 in this case? 101 means what? Which register?
EBP.
EBP.
EBP. So I don't have any option with mod 0 with ABP. Correct? We don't have any option for EBP. You can see that. But sorry, 101 is a ESP, I think. Yeah, EBP, sorry, EBP, we should have taken, I should have talked. This EBP, we don't have any option over here to be written in the square bracket. That means what? This would be picked whenever you are referring to a variable which is from the local stack. And as it is a local variable declared in your data section, though it is said to be global, but it is declared inside your code. That's why it is going to take it from that particular place, your internal stack of the code. That's why that EBP came into picture. And that's why it is taking this 101 as a mod. So whenever you are referring to a variable which is part of your code, which is included along with the immediate data, this would be considered there as an 101 to be one of the part of mod IM byte. Now, if I try to compare, say, let me create space so that we can see everything there. So we are talking about this 8105 now. So 8105 we took like this. So it is 81000101. And for that add also, we got the same thing. 81100011. This was dependent on what parameter you have. If it is other than ESP EBP, what may happen if I write add ESP comma something or add EBP comma something then over there? If I write at all like this, what should happen? Should it throw an error or what? Okay, let me try that part as well. So we'll change this to ESP and EBP. Fine, let us try generating this code. So we never have got an error. Now see this. Now when it talked about ESP EBP with mod, there is no problem for 11. Okay, because mod is 11 in this case. That's why you can see that it is picked from here. It was something like C3, C4, sorry, C4, C5. See here, sorry, LST. We got C4 and C5. That is not the problem. But whenever we are talking about mod 00, with mod 00, this ESP EBP will never occur in a square bracket. Right? Likewise, if I, for example, try this, Emacs, this to see the mod RM. Now see what it says. Operation size not specified. Okay, let us try to correct this. Emacs. So if I say in this case D word. I specified that size too. Now if I go to this translation and see the LST, what is shown there? 8104 and 8145. Whenever it became a square bracket with ESP EBP, so actually it talked about the column of ESP EBP there. You can see here. It is talking about this column somewhere. What was the code? 04 and 45. Where is 04? This. And 45. Where is 45? This. EBP plus displacement 8. correct? Because we are not adding anything into EBP. Displacement rate means zero. EBP plus zero actually it took. That's why it is showing this 45 and 05. And both of the in both the cases, mod was different. So it doesn't mean that we are not permitted to make use of them. But if I use it, it doesn't make sense because whenever I write this, ultimately I am trying to add this value into the stack. That's what the meaning would be. I would be adding this and then storing value to stack pointer. Actually, stack pointer is representing something else. ESP will not have its own identity. It would have identity only when a stack is created, stack is demolished. Same case would be probably true for EBP, but EBP would be permitted because it would be stack frame to store your local variables. But the original stack that you have, it would be really problematic situations whenever you try to write this code. So shall I write this code this way? Maybe for trial purpose, yes, but in reality, you never write this kind of code. Though it is showing you the translation for both of these lines. You never write this. Probably I'm only mainly interested or keen about this. You should avoid using this kind of stuff every time. Then what would be such situation? Because what exactly you are doing, you don't know what is the stack pointer at that particular time point of time. What operation, if you make any change in the stack pointer, ultimately everything can collapse. Correct. So let me create an executable. Okay. 32 ELF 32, yes, GCC dash M 32 2007.o. Now you will see that whenever I try to do this, I am going to get this segmentation fault. And if I try to debug this code, basically that error would be because of that ESP, because you are trying to enter into some system area which you are not permitted to. Correct. You might have seen similar kind of error rather on probably the Turbo C editor. Can you recall you saw some error called L value required? Have you heard this error?
Yes, sir, sometime.
What exactly that is? So it's similar sister thing that we say, sister. Kind of or whatever, I don't know what relation you should put there, but sister companies like that. So sister error in Linux is segmentation fault. Yeah, somebody was talking about something. Yeah, what you are saying? Somebody was saying
nothing,
something.
Sir.
Okay. So if I go to next instruction, you will see that whenever we reach to that ESP, see what it does. So it said ESP I worked, but when you are talking about your internal EBP, which is itself is a stack pointer, you are trying to move to that address, which is not permitted. That's why it says received a signal and that caused segmentation fault. Because you violated segment. Segment means whenever our program gets loaded into memory, there are two kinds of memory area. One is called as user area, one is called as system area. So you might be trying to enter into the area which is prohibited. You are not permitted to enter into that area, and actually you are doing that thing. Correct, because this EBP actually is working as a stack pointer for the stack frame created internally. Okay, now let me show you how. So let us display ESP EBP. Let me run them, both of them. So you have this. So it would be really confusing if you try to see these contents. Okay, now concentrate on EBP value and ESP value. Now see, have you seen some change with ESP data? So it got executed here, correct? This got executed here. That result should have been stored here, but has it made any change in the ESP? please check this one and this one. The values yes. represented by ESP, are they same?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then why do you think it is not making any change there? This instruction doesn't make any sense for it. This would be like generally you write character CH and you don't use CH at all in your code. So this would be called as dead code. Some part is written, suppose integer I is never used, but you are saying I++. What is the achievement there by incrementing I++? If you are not going to use I further in either of the case, what exactly you achieved with I++? So some part of code is dead code. Okay, have you heard this terminology? Dead code terminology? Okay, let me tell you where exactly it can be found. Now I assume in TCS, though I'm referring to that course because there is this concept added, correct? In TCS, you do talk about transition diagrams, correct? Now, yes. How, on what basis you say a string is accepted by finite state meta?
When it reaches to the final state.
Final state, yes. So you are parsing the string or you are following every character from the string from the start state and you reach to final state. Suppose you are parsing some string and you are taken to some state which is not final. So you generally say what? This is not an accepted string, correct? But sometimes what happens is there is some state which is seen there, but it is never used in finding out the transitions. Suppose A to B, A to C, A to D are the transitions. Okay, but there is one transition from F to A. And there is no incoming transition for F. Or A, B, C, D, E are having all internal outgoing incoming transitions. Okay, but for F, there is only outgoing transition from F. Now, do you think that F transition would be used at all? No, because you cannot reach to F in any case. So that kind of state is called as dead state. In code as well, we write some part of code which never gets executed in its whole life of the program. And that kind of code is called as dead code. And that dead code might be removed from the system. And in this case, though we write this line, it is not going to make any change here because it doesn't have any control. So though we received here the error, now you try to see what happens here. Has it changed the data of EBP? No. But what exactly you are trying to do? You are trying to play with the stack frame created for it. That is the reason why it is showing you segmentation fault, because you violated the segment violated. This is signal generated and that is called as segmentation fault. I generally use this line, like whenever I teach assembly programming, I do say this, if you don't, or even when you write a C program, if you don't get segmentation fault error, ultimately your life is worth, sorry, not worth. Because once you should get that L value error, like segmentation fault. And it is very difficult sometimes to find out or recover from this error. You never know until unless you debug where is exactly the problem. Because suppose if I don't debug and if I execute like this, I don't know where exactly the issue is, what caused the segmentation fault. And if you don't have any idea about using GDB, it is ultimately too difficult for an individual to really find out what is the reason for that segmentation fault. This is a really important thing that needs to be accessed or accepted. Though it is showing us some code generated, an object code, but at loader level, your code will never get executed. So this information is actually passed to it, but additional information is added there when it adds that object code. Because if I see obj dump dash d a dot out pipe place. So let us go to that main. start. So yeah, this frame dummy is stack creation. Okay, so it creates clones for all registers, and now here our main is. Now you can see these instructions added. Correct. So translation is added, but this instruction, though it is added, now you may wonder why that L is added over here. Because it is a long value. You are referring to memory address. This also is memory address. This also is memory address. That's why that L is added with add. But opcode is not changing. 81 is the opcode, same opcode. Though it translated this, but whenever mod RM comes to 04 or 45, it is going to return you a segmentation fault. And that segmentation fault would be like added or was added because of this undefined reference that you are trying to access through these two instructions. You are not permitted to access these memory locations. That's what it is trying to tell us. Understood? Any question, please? Yes? Any question? Can you ask? Like, if you have any question, please ask me so that we can solve that problem. Have you understood what I was trying to tell? Now think of this. Like, suppose these are four memory area that are allocated. Correct. Now this was Prathamesh, Jaspal, Lalit, and Samiksha. Now how many things, like if I talk about these different four processes, what Samiksha can access from Lalit's memory, Lalit's area, or Jaspal's area, or Prathamesh area, covered by or accessed by these three. There can be limited access, or there can be like the case that access is not granted. Now, when access is not granted, if still I try to do this, what should happen? An error should be thrown. And that thrown error is mainly the segmentation fault. You are not permitted to access, but you are still trying to access it on your own. This is not permitted at all. And that's one major issue with this kind of coding. OK, so we do write this instruction and we assume that, OK, what exactly I did? I added to ESP, I added to EBP. My problem should be sufficed, but actually it is not. It is not going to help you out in any case. So suggestion given for good programming is avoid such kind of memory references. Otherwise you would be thrown a segmentation fault. That segmentation fault would be occurring always as a runtime error. Now, when I said L value error was with respect to compilation time. OK, so at compilation time only it is really verified over there. When I say object code creation in Turbo C, we never worried about whether there is an assembler included there. But actually, whenever your compiler is trying to compile code, compiler's output is assembly code, and assembly code is taken by your standard assembler to generate object code. Even your .NET framework has its own inbuilt assembler inside, which takes that bytecode. Your Java is having JVM, which is exactly working with your bytecode to translate it. Correct? Are you with me? Any question? Yes, please. Shall I ask my questions? Are you there? Can you hear me? I'm not getting any response from at all from you people.
Yes, sir, we are hearing.
Only here, but not respond in non-responsive mode, correct? Yeah, so have you understood what I was trying to tell?
Somewhat so.
Okay, so think over it, chew it, and if you find any difficulty with this, because like this might be somewhat related to your operating system, somewhat related to your databases. Okay, when I am trying to see, like you are trying to access data from other thing, that's why I am saying data structures, operating systems. Okay, it is related that way because you are trying to access some memory area which is prohibited. Now there is something like in operating system book, you must have seen a chapter called protection or memory protection. So it is coming into picture over here while we try to access this kind of code, or when a user is trying to write such kind of code over there. That comes into picture rather every time whenever you are trying to access something which you are not permitted to. Fine. Okay, have you understood the philosophy behind having same opcode in this case? Can you tell me what might be the reason that they added this kind of stuff over there? They could have taken one more opcode. Like there are 100 opcodes, adding one should not be a problem. But why then they could have come up with this solution? Because these 3 bytes are telling you which instruction it is. You have to note this down, correct? Like you can have screen, like anyway, I'm going to send this file to you. Let me save this first. Yeah, we gave it trial.txt. So let me share it with you peoples so that you can use those files for understanding what exactly I was trying to tell. Yes, any question, like you can go through it, think over it, like you have complete day now. So how many of you could think over, like though I haven't added due to my own problems in respect of not finding the time to add assignments there. Somebody reminded me that I'll be adding that. Have you worked with the part of implementing mod RM byte or SIB byte? Have you worked with it?